Our mission statement is more than just words. It is our guidepost, what we come back to time and again as we seek to follow in the path of Jesus and embolden others to do the same. Each and every day, our Holy Family Catholic Community clergy, staff, and parishioners like you put this mission at the forefront of what we do, in big ways and in small.
So back when the pandemic happened, we realized that there was a need for the homeless to go somewhere. So we opened the back of St. Mary's and we just let them come in the back of church. We had offered some food and they were so appreciative of a place to go. So fast forward to November and December of 2020, and this problem was still there. So we opened up St. Mary's Outreach Center at the time. Now we call it the Holy Family Outreach Center.
Each day is different. We spend time visiting with the visitors that are in our shelter. They often ask us for help, connecting with resources, and the opportunity to celebrate when someone gets an apartment and begins moving forward. Even the clients that, even our visitors, I mean, we all celebrate together. It's wonderful to see somebody move up and out.
Blessed Bites started about a year and a half ago in Fond du Lac with the Holy Family being the sponsor. The Human Concerns Commission and Holy Family together decided to put something together that would put food on the table for individuals on a regular basis. And in most cases, a lot of the things that you see here with the hygiene items and so forth and the food, canned food and things like that, all disappears. We have a special individual that shows up every once in a while. His name is Nico. I believe he's 3 years old. He knows how to count in Spanish. And when he shows up, he comes over and gets an item or two from here. He helps his dad get food in the bags and also gives us a smile and so forth. So it's really kind of neat to be able to provide the types of things that Holy Family has done here on a regular basis.
Last October, we launched Neighbors in Faith. And what it does is basically connects neighbors and neighbors. So for example, we had a woman who needed help with getting her yard shoveled when it got really deep and she couldn't do it. She lives in a condo, hard for her to do that herself. So we paired her with a gentleman who does that for her. Whenever it's over 2 inches, he comes on over and he does the shoveling and then they have coffee together. So it's not just, you know, helping out, but it's also building relationships with people.
One of the biggest things that I've seen for RCIA, for adults, when the adults are coming into the church, sometimes they come in way later in life and they may have been attending Catholic church for quite some time with their spouses, and then they finally made the decision that, you know, Christ is calling them to the Catholic church. And being at Easter Vigil and seeing them receive the sacraments, oh, it's just the most amazing thing.
I started in 1985 in De Pere and did it through 2000, and we moved here in 2001. And then so from 2001 until present. Did it by myself, and then about 3 years ago, my wife's like, I want to join you in RCIAS. So that's been a tremendous experience teaching with her, but we've been humbled, really, by some of these, you know, us being both cradle Catholics, and you see the faithfulness and just on the love of Christ from these people who are brand new to the faith, and you're like learning from them.
One thing that I don't think that the many people understand about Christian formation is how much fun the students actually are. Like, they're actually hilarious. I don't know, you go to some of these classes and there's just this huge energy. They're asking questions, they're like, why do you wear black? Why do you dress up with that dress when you go up to the altar? And they want to know, like, why is it that we worship God the way that we do? And so, like, the catechists are able to answer a ton of those questions, but the priest is also able to answer a lot of those questions and to be able to feed their minds and their hearts. So they grow up knowing that they're not alone. They live in a relationship with God, and they have an opportunity to experience that relationship with God every day in their prayer and every week in the Mass of Sunday.
When I go to Holy Family, I kind of like get to receive Christ and I get to grow in my faith.
You get to learn about new things and you get to learn more about God and Jesus, and not all people get to do that. I liked how the priests came into our classroom because you can get to know them better, and if there's like hard questions, they can answer it for you. Like once I had this question, like, why aren't the people in the Old Testament saints? And Father Justin answered it.
Holy Family, they send priests over every week for Friday Mass, morning Mass for the high school, and for like middle school, they'll have priests come over, so that's very helpful. They have priests come in every week, every Wednesday, for our weekly campus ministry lunch. Just talk to us, we're doing a Lenten study right now. For the campus ministry interns, we have a meeting with a priest once every 2 weeks just to check in, like sort of see how they can pray for us or how they can help us with our faith lives.
For me, what's been helpful is to be able to engage the students outside of the context of Sunday Mass. Because oftentimes, yeah, after Mass, you're sitting in the back, you're shaking hands, you're saying hello, goodbye. It's just very quick. And their only interaction with you is through the Mass, is through the sacraments. What's nice about getting to go on like the retreats with the high school students, what's nice about getting to go on some of the field trips or getting to like see their sports games or to visit their classrooms, or when some of the high schoolers come up and eat lunch with us on Wednesday afternoons. What's great about that is they can see a bit more of the humanity of the priest. They can understand in a broader way, you know, vocations in the life of the church.
We've been Holy Family members forever. Deacon Larry baptized me at St. Joseph's when I was young, and then just going up and growing to Springs, and obviously they've been interconnected through all of that. I think Holy Family has been a part of every key step in my faith journey. I get to have meetings one-on-one with Father every other Friday, and then not only do I have that, but he's also like my priest I go to every Sunday at Mass. I go to 10 o'clock at Our Risen Savior, he's there every week. So I think like being able to see him out in the community and also like personally in the school has just like built our relationship, and I think that's like allowed me to draw closer to God.
We are not meant to live this life alone. We are meant to live the Catholic life in community. I think it's perfect that we have the name Holy Family for our parish, because that is essentially like what we are trying to be. We are family here together as parishioners, and maybe we have our own families within the parish, but also we are trying to be holy as well, and so all of that kind of comes into play as we grow together.
So far, I have spent 4 years in this parish. And when I came, I started to know the community at St. Mary. That was the place where we celebrated the Mass. And then, you know, came the pandemic. And it was like a stop in all the things that we have in mind to create. But now, we moved after this pandemic to celebrate the Mass here at Holy Family, the big church. And I see that the community has grown. Now we have at least 320 people at Mass, and that Sunday Mass, and we have so many activities, more than before.
Since being a part of the parish, I have had more joy in my life, more happiness. And I think the biggest thing is the peace that I've had. That, like, I get goosebumps right now, but it's just so beautiful to see that, you know, we're united as one and that we all are together in this and in the faith, that it opens up people's hearts, and the more that we see the changes within 1 year to another, it's just like more people want to get involved to continue that.
What I can see in this short period, it is that the Holy Family community is a community that really wants to fulfill the commandment of Jesus Christ to preach the gospel. So it is an important thing because it is making differences in the life of people and in the whole community.